Despite the Trump administration's efforts to scale back the health law, about 300,000 more people have signed up for health insurance in the Affordable Care Act marketplaces in the first weeks of this enrollment period than last year. First 2 weeks of Healthcare.gov enrollment note weekly beta was not available for the 2014 open enrollment period. But it's still early in the 2018 enrollment period, and people who sign up early are often those who need healthcare the most. Cumulative Healthcare.gov enrollment note: the Obama administration extended the enrollment period by 1 week in 2015 to allow more time to sign up. Because the Trump administration cut the enrollment period in half this year, to 45 days from 3 months, weekly sign-ups would need to double to match the number of sign-ups in previous years. The deadline to sign up this year is December 15th in most states. Last enrollment period, it was Jan. 31. CumulativeHealthcare.gov enrollment: when enrollment period ends this year, there are usually two spikes during the enrollment period, one in the middle and one near the end. The first spike is from people signing up before the end of the calendar year in order to get coverage that starts on Jan. 1. The final spike tends to have a higher share of young and healthy people, who are more likely to sign up as a result of outreach and advertising. These two groups are also crucial to the health law's success because they help balance out the cost of insuring the old and sick. Weekly Healthcare.gov enrollment: during the last enrollment period, the Trump administration canceled ads days before the deadline, and the enrollment spike wilted compared with past years. Research has shown that repeated television advertising increases enrollment. But with the Trump administration's decision to cut the law's advertising budget by 90% this year, it is possible that the last minute spike that helped boost enrollment in past years will disappear. Source numbers are based on weekly and bi-weekly enrollment numbers released by the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services. A daily average was calculated, then totaled into the number of enrollees per week.